years ago, I received an invitation from Roberto Zavala here at CSA Sureste in San Cristobal to teach a seminar together with my colleague Harold Torres at UCLA, to teach a seminar on free relative clauses and to train the students and the scholars here to explore this construction.
El único programa en el mundo que tiene esta cualidad de entrenar a gente que no sabe nada de lingüística hasta formarlos como lingüistas en un periodo bastante corto.
I really like this project because, again, it's sort of bringing together native speaker linguists and also people who, you know, like me, who are not native speakers of any Mesoamerican language, and sort of bringing together these perspectives and saying, hey, let's see what we can figure out about particular areas of the grammars of these languages. And now everybody, now that we've sort of brainstormed together about this, now everyone, let's go out and document these languages.
El programa empezó, ya tiene 20 años más o menos, pero era un programa muy distinto. Al principio no era un programa para formar lingüistas, sino era un programa que se les daba entrenamiento para poder hablar de sus lenguas en términos de vitalidad o de cómo hacer que escribieran sus lenguas, pero no era un programa de formación de lingüística. Pero esto cambió a partir de 2001, que cambiamos el programa para que fuera un programa realmente de formación de lingüística y con una cualidad muy importante, que todos los estudiantes fueran hablantes de los idiomas.
It involves a lot of native speaker linguists. So one of the things that can make it very difficult and makes progress slow in terms of describing and documenting languages is that being a native speaker of a language and having intuitions about the language is enormously helpful. And so, you know, I work on languages, you know, at these languages as a linguist, but if you're a native speaker, you have a lot of intuitions about the kinds of sentences that would be good or bad, or the right way to pronounce a sentence, all these things that, you know, come from being a native speaker. So having a group of native speakers who are linguists or linguists in training is extremely valuable, because then these linguists and linguists in training can go back to their native speaker communities and sort of either continue or, you know, kickstart the description and documentation of their own native languages.
Harold and I were very excited about the seminar. I think the people at CSS were very excited too, and we decided to continue this project, to make it bigger, to make it more articulated, and in particular to create a project that would allow young scholar or very promising graduate students who are becoming linguists, bringing their knowledge of the language as native speakers or close native speakers of the language, create a project in which all this knowledge would produce something visible, something concrete, and something that could be useful to the linguistic community in general, not just to a small group of linguists. In particular, we decided to work together on a broad cross-linguistic investigation of a certain kind of relative clauses, headless relative clauses, across many Mesoamerican languages. Project is going to bring visibility to young scholars and very promising graduate students who are doing like groundbreaking work on Mesoamerican languages that may not receive the very same amount of attention if their work were not published in a major venue in English. And our volume will appear with a major publisher, Oxford University Press, and will be in English. In this way, we hope that to bring attention to headless relative clauses and Mesoamerican language. So it's a way to build a bridge between a strong community of linguists who have investigated, are investigating Mesoamerican languages in depth, and the broader linguistic community who may be interested in a variety, in different aspects and richness that comes from Mesoamerican languages.